Gone Home, this month's free PlayStation game. Modifiers and commentary. Or start. Wait, should I go look at this modifiers and commentary? Let's see. All lights start on. Disable map.
I just threw the commentary on.
Enable commentary. All right.
Start. We kind of got to talk together so we know. Like, I kind of want to be in the same like room so we know what we're doing.
Yeah, I don't think
stay together.
Shit's broadcasting. I don't think my shit went. I don't think my shit broadcasted. It's doing that weird thing. It's again.
Hi, Mom.
I think it will broadcast
so I got
eventually.
My ticket home from Europe.
Oh, there it
I
goes.
Get back on June 6th, but it's a really late flight because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport, so you don't have to pick me up. Like really seriously, you don't have to.
June
7th, okay, so
1995.
Love you.
See you soon.
1:15
a.m.
God damn. I was 8 years old. Not even.
I was six.
Of course you were six. You're still six.
Let me know when you're at... Let me know when you're at the... You're in the game.
June 7th, 1995. 1:15 a.m. Front door. Standing here with my bag.
Alright.
Caitlin Green Breyer, Portland. Flight 270, day June 6, 1995. Oh! I don't know. Okay, so R1 is a map. And then inside it. Ew, this broad is ugly. Journal.
1995, kid.
I don't. Flight 270, seat 16F, Amsterdam to Portland, through Cincinnati. Caitlin Greenbrier, seat 16F. This is my boarding pass back from my year in Europe. It's my passport. I got it to go on my Europe trip. Map, front porch, journals, nothing. Okay. This bitch got a flashlight, she's gonna get mugged. Any other button to do anything? Ooh. Could also use triangle for the map screen. Okay.
It's only left and right analog stick and X button.
Circle the squat. Doing some squats.
Right.
Yeah, we gotta do some squats and exercise. Enough of this. Ooh, zoom in with the directional button. Open door. Steve Gaynor, welcome to commentary mode. Okay. Door is locked. That means that there's a key somewhere. Gotta find the key.
Yeah, down. I know where the key... I know where it is.
Don't fucking tell me.
Alright.
It's obviously gonna be under this cup.
House key added to backpack.
Find the key. Oh, the lamp is on. Aha. Found the key. House key added
Did
to
you?
Backpack. Yeah, it's on the dock. Do you know that?
So
yeah, we got a letter here.
Dog, is a fan favorite. He's kind of a
Wait, hold on.
Mascot, I guess. And I think that's
It's on the door.
I'm listening to the Christmas dog.
Weird duck. Concept. Christmas.
Are you
duck,
listening to it?
Because it's like the first unique
Yeah, you
thing
listen to the commentary.
In the game. It's kind of personifies the whole character.
What did it say?
Christmas duck was not planned. When we were starting the project, we didn't have a 3D modeler because Kate came on a couple months after.
It was $5.99 this Christmas duck.
We needed a bunch of 3D models, and so I was just going through the Unity asset store So I was going through the list and saw this Christmas.
Hi, I'm Steve Gaynor. I'm the co-founder of the Fulbright Company. We made Gone Home. I was the...
So Christmas.
Oh, this commentary is weird. I don't like this.
He's a fan favorite. He's kind of a...
We're going inside the house.
Mascot,
okay.
Which, I guess. And I think that's...
Did you read the thing?
What
no
thing?
Weird.
I only just got in the front door.
Christmas duck.
And no, it's on the front door.
Unique thing that you encounter.
No, it ain't.
In the game. It's kind of personifies the whole...
Before you get in, there's a note on the front door.
Christmas duck was not planned. When we were starting the project, we were just...
Katie, I'm sorry I can't be there to see you, but it is impossible. Please don't go digging around trying to find out where I am.
The Unity asset store. So
I don't want anyone to know. We'll see each other again someday. Don't be worried. I love you, Sam.
We used it as like a test object just to set up the system where you can grab stuff and carry it around. And then I ended up saying, all right, we got this Christmas duck. I'll hide the key under it. And instead of replacing the free model with a totally different thing, just made a real version of it. And Carlo and we kept him in the game. And we're glad because he's everybody's little friend. Good old Christmas duck.
Hi, Riddick. What?
Alright, for those of you viewing at home, I'm going to take a quick break, and in the meantime, listen to the Christmas Duck once again.
So, Christmas Duck. Christmas Duck is a fan favorite. He's kind of a mascot, I guess, and I think that's partly because it's a weird concept, Christmas Duck, and partly because it's like the first unique thing that you encounter.
Yeah, you also can also check out streaming on Twitch. Anybody.
But the thing is, Christmas Duck was not planned. When we were starting the project, we didn't have a 3D modeler because Kate came on a couple months after we started, and we needed a bunch of 3D models. And so I was just going through the Unity asset store. So I was going through the list and saw this Christmas duck, and I was like, "What is that?" Okay, and I grabbed it, and we used it as like a test object just to set up the system where you can grab stuff and carry it around. And then I ended up saying, "All right, we got this Christmas duck. I'll hide the key under it." And instead of replacing the free model with a totally different thing, just made a real version of it. And Carla modeled it, and Kate textured it, and we kept him in the game. And we're glad because he's everybody's little friend. Good old Christmas duck.
1 hour and 10 minutes.
Hi, I'm Steve Gaynor. I'm the co-founder of the Fulbright Company. We made Gone Home. I was the writer and designer.
Have a doggone cool savage.
Thank you for taking a look at
Sam
our commentary
Harvey
mode. Whenever you find an icon like the one you just clicked on, you can find out a little bit more about the game. I want to thank everybody who's...
This is one of these games where you're going to have to
Yanman and Carla,
comb like through every single
3D artist
detail.
Chris Remo, our composer, Sarah Grayson,
because
the
it could potentially
Sam Greenbrier
help
and
us.
Tucker,
so basically,
the
game
lead singer of Heaven's
is there's really no objective in the game.
So thank you, everybody, and enjoy commentary.
We just kind of have to figure out what happened to this family. What is her little sister hiding? Is another thing. Terrence Greenbrier. I'm guessing this is her father. Actually, we looked at it. We kind of know a little bit about the family, which I read about. Basically, the father is some sort of author, and he's one that is not successful, is having a hard time being published and whatnot. And here's guess this is a movers. Movers slip. The word I'm looking for, like an invoice. Description of shipment content. Boxes, kitchen. Boxes, master bed. Boxes, child bed. Boxes, overweight library. Boxes, office, television. Continued packing on delivery insurance. 2% to cover total loss. Total and grand balance. So I don't know if they're. So while you're combing through all the evidence, so to say, you will hear the sister talk like diary excerpts on some stuff. I guess what I've just gathered, they're not moving out, they just moved into this new house. I'm gonna try to collab here. I'm gonna try not to comb through too many details when he's gone. Pick up old track trophy. Hey, regional track field finals, April 1991, girls long jump event, Caitlin Green. Briar, first place.
Alright, and I'm back. Where's this note? Let's see. Okay, door. Note. Katie. Sorry, I can't be there to see you, but it's impossible. Interesting. Please. Please don't go digging around to find out where I am. I don't want anyone to know. We'll see each other again someday. Don't be worried. I love you, Sam. Interesting. Let's take this note. How do we take this off the door?
Can't.
Bullshit. Give me this fucking note. Let's see. There's some interesting bits that are in here. Let's see. We've got Mom and Dad is crossed out. See each other again someday.
Yeah, which is.
And don't go digging
which
around.
Which is wit. Double, please don't go digging around.
Yeah.
We'll see each other again someday. Don't be worried. I love you.
Are you?
But
still
we know that it's.
Are you still looking at
what?
The note, or did you move forward?
I went back to the note. Oh. I went all the way to the left, and looked at this invoice.
Alright, so we read the note, we're going inside, all the way to the left. Look at the invoice. It's a box that says front hall on it. Box is a
correct.
Box. Ooh, wait, hold on. Oh, lamp is on. Let's take a look at this folder. Read invoice. Movers. Screen Briar. Destination full booking number 427, August 1st of 94. And what are we, June of 95? So what is that, a year before? This thing is dated a year earlier.
Yeah, that's the weird thing, isn't it? So maybe this house has been like this for this long. Because I kind of know, I read a little bit of it on a Wikipedia on like the backstory. And basically, Terrence is her father. And he's an author, but he's a he's trying to get his shit published, but he's not doing, getting the job done. That's what I know about the father.
Yeah, so they obviously moved here, and then she went away, and
Dear
then she
Katie,
just came back.
Oh. So much has changed, even just since you've been away.
Where did the fuck journal so come from?
We moved into this house. I'm
yeah, and
school.
What's going to happen is when you go
and
to certain evidence,
gone for a year,
you're
going to
hear the
easier.
Sister talk.
It doesn't feel real.
So it should have started talking when you picked
but
up
I'm not
that invoice.
Let it faze me.
That's the first
I
one.
I used to tell you everything, and if I can't do it in person, because you're off gallivanting around, who knows
Let
where.
Me know when you're going,
I'll
what room you're going
to
go
journal,
to next.
Just uh-huh. like I was talking to you.
Bathroom. Oh, let's keep the faucet running. Just kidding, we'll turn it off. Want to be green. Grab the hand soap.
Turn on faucet.
Hand
Grab
soap.
Hand soap.
There's nothing going on with the hand soap, so that's... Ooh, I just dropped it on the floor.
Did you actually pick it up and examine it?
Yeah, and then I dropped it on the floor.
Because I think that's going to be the main thing, picking up things and examining.
Yeah, I just flushed the toilet. Ooh, can we turn on the light? Yes. Turn on the lights. Hang on, I gotta take a shit.
They won't let you. Opening sliding door. Towels in the front side left.
What?
More towels.
Get published the secret, the blank page, how 20 top authors conquer it, okay?
Are you examining the magazine?
Yeah, or at least I wasn't. It doesn't... This is February of 95 issue. So this is already now 4 months old. Because we're in June. Okay. Toilet paper.
Anything?
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Soft plus toilet tissue for your money. Have a date on it. Unscented. See what we got here. Grab box. Bandages. Made in the USA. Got another box. More bandages. Chuck that. Got some teepee. Normal toilet paper. Some more teepee. Nothing out of the ordinary. There's another box. Some more bandages. What the hell kind of people need so many bandages for? Cleaning powder. Vax. Cleaning powder. Pale hair. Cleaning product. More cleaning powder. only viable. Regional track and field finals, April 21st, 1990, girls 100 meter relay, first place, Jamie Bloom, Carla Jones, and Shauna Rossi, Caitlin Greenbrier. We got a skullhead. Hecho en Mexico. Made in Mexico. Well, the trophy. I guess this broad was a runner. This is my passport. I got it to go on a Europe trip. Boarding pass. Departure, Amsterdam. Destination, Portland. Transfer in Cincinnati. Caitlin Greenbrier. Breyer. Flight number 270, 16F. Well, the front porch and the foyer. So much has changed even just since you've been gone. We moved into this house. I'm at a new school, and my big sister being gone for a year doesn't make it any easier. Doesn't feel real, but I'm not going to let it faze me. I used to tell you everything, and if I can't do it in person because you're off gallivanting around who knows where, I'll tell it to this journal, just like I was talking to you. All right, we're gonna keep going, I guess. From the bathroom, we're just gonna keep heading left. Look at this draw. We have an itinerary. Domestic reservation.
Oh, there you are. That's why you're not talking. Opening the door. No, this is some creepy shit. Turn on the lights.
Yeah.
Okay.
Where are you?
It's a
bathroom?
Hallway. Nah, it's all, I just left the bathroom. We're not going down that room. Don't go down that room. Don't go down the room. Don't even turn the lights on. That's some creepy shit. Don't do it. Don't do it.
Wait.
Oh, wait. Oh.
Where are
what
you?
Is this? And that little alcove area to the left of the bathroom. To the left of the stairs.
Did you look inside any of the drawers or anything?
Not yet.
Man, mom handwriting.
Wide timetable.
Went through a lot of
effective
moms
June 1st, 1994.
A lot of different moms contributed handwriting for him. At first...
domestic reservation, international reservation. Katie's departure.
But her handwriting was
7694. Flight 881, 1210 to Amsterdam.
I think we actually had Yaman try to do it for a while before he was dad's handwriting. And then we got
it's like almost 2 years.
And
she was gone. For
it. Really good mom handwriting.
What?
Yeah.
Hold on.
Hi, Mom.
You didn't even.
So
did you pick up the,
I get back on
play
Tuesday
the messages?
Really
I'm doing that now.
Because that was the cheapest, so it gets in at midnight. But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle from the airport so you don't have to pick me up. Like, really seriously, you don't have to. Okay, so. Love you. See you soon. Bye.
So that's all the messages. Let's read this note. Again. Neighbor called, wants to see the new house, call him back. Mom, Daniel is a total weirdo. The only reason I ever hung out with him in the first place, is he had a Nintendo when we were little. Alright, you a gold digger, B.
Did you hear the second message?
Yeah, about the shuttle.
Oh. Why is she crying?
Listen again.
Sam.
Sam.
So the first one's her, the second one's her, the sister, and the third one is
Sam.
Who we are, the character.
Sam, where are you? Really?
So this is a conversation between the mother and Sam, the sister.
Could be the brother.
No, the family's right here.
Hi, Mom.
There ain't
I got
no
my ticket
problem.
Home from Europe. I get back on June 6th, but it's
this
a
is
really
the picture
late
right here.
That was the cheapest, so it gets
father.
But don't worry, I'll get a shuttle.
His name is Terry.
So you don't have to pick me up. Like, really seriously, you don't have to.
The mother, which her name is
okay,
Jan.
So, love you. See you soon.
And then
bye.
Sam. And then Katie is the one up top. Now I'm all the way to the left in this hallway.
No, don't do that. You missed some meh. Did you come to the right of the stairs?
Anything?
There's a Bible. Threw it on the floor. Trophy.
Yeah, I checked out the trophies,
okay, so
which I found out that yeah, she's an athlete.
H1 Mexico.
Here's another letter.
Wait, hold on. Oh, well, let me do it upside down.
It's a letter to the mother. It's so good to hear from you again. All this new house business sounds quite the adventure. Remember the little dorm room we shared freshman year when we were miserable, fantasizing about our dream homes? I always said I wanted a mansion. You said you just wanted a house in the woods. Look who got both. Somebody up there likes you. I could use some of that magic. Send me some lotto numbers. I'll play them seriously. But I shouldn't be complaining about this good old split level we've had since Bob got transferred to Winnipeg. We just got new final siding. Jealous yet? Let me know if you ever want to trade places. So how are the girls doing? Has Katie left on her big European adventure yet? Speaking of jealous. Right back soon. I miss you, Rumi, Carol. Okay, nothing. How's this? Telephone directory, 1995. So the stuff from 94, 95, and 96.
Why is this door locked?
That I don't know.
Yeah, well, 95 makes sense that it's the telephone directory.
Tissue box.
Where'd you see the tissue box?
Right where the entrance door is, there's a...
Tissue box. Let's see. It's empty, so someone was...
Read note. Directions to work from new house. Left on Grabtree, right on Bullhorn. Exit on the 47N, right onto 202E. Entrance on right past Wage Road. Travel time 1 hour and 10 minutes.
They didn't go to work.
What?
They're in Arbor Hill.
I did find something behind the arrow.
It's in this third door.
But it's only a birthday card. Have a doggone cool 17th birthday. Happy birthday, Sam, Uncle Harvey.
Oh. Huh. This one is
why is it behind there?
Must have fallen off the thing.
Now I'm in a closet.
Oh, you're finally gonna come out? Oh, what is this?
Closet, Forestry Service, Janice.
Janice is a Greenbrier Senior Conservatorist. Front hall.
Nothing in here, though.
Wait. It's a board game.
Over the Alps, a novel travel game.
Alright, this closet's got nothing. Goodfellow High School. It's an owl. Dare we go up the stairs? Or do you want to go down that hall first?
I would say stay on the same level first. That hall has a lot of stuff.
Oh, I don't want to go down this hallway. Nothing ever good comes from a hallway. Another closet. Ooh. First closet on the left. Welcome, new student. We hope that you are as excited about your first day at Goodfellow High School as we are. Please be sure to bring the following with you on your first day of classes so that you can get right into the swing of things. One sturdy folder with six pockets for each of your six class periods. One line notebook period, or one large notebook with six divided sections, at least six pens, six pencils, one box of colored pencils, a standard combination lock for your assigned locker, a nutritious lunch or $2.50 for a lunch provided by the school cafeteria, a positive attitude. And why are they all crossed off except for a positive attitude? This bitch was not happy. Please remember to get plenty of sleep the night before and be ready for the first bell to ring at 8 a.m. See you soon and welcome again. Beth Valence, principal.
Oh my god.
Journal.
You are so lucky you finished high school before we moved into this house. So, it's the first day of school, and there I am, introducing myself to the class. And I say that I just moved into the house on Arbor Hill. All of a sudden, every kid in the room turns and just stares like I suddenly transformed into a mutant. I just stood there, wishing pretty hard for a rewind button. Because now maybe nobody knows my name, but they all know who I am. The Psycho House Girl. Great.
Psycho House Girl?
Okay, this is getting creepy.
But why is she the Psycho House Girl? I don't get
it. Because obviously there's something wrong with this house.
Oh, grab button. Heavens to Betsy. You can grab it.
Yeah, and then throw it on the floor.
Is there anything on the back of it?
A pin.
Useless.
Close the door, there's writing on the wall.
Is there?
Just kidding.
Scared.
I don't want to keep doing this. Okay. Out of that room. Bureau on the right. Pack of cards. Article. Read the article.
Inside the drawer?
Yeah.
Check the pack of cards. I chuck it on the floor.
Yeah, I chuck everything on the floor. That way I know that we've already looked at it.
Obituary. Oscar Doc Mason, 60 of Boone County, died peacefully last month in his home. Mr. Mason was born on September 8th, 1933 in the house. That would be his home for the rest of his life. He had attained a degree in pharmacy at a young age, turned to Boone County to practice. He quickly became a well-loved figure, center of the community. In the decades preceding his passing, he had seldom seen outside his home. A service will be held on Sunday at the First Methodist Church at 1 p.m. All are welcome. His survivors include his nephew, Terrence Greenbrier, as well as in spirit the people of Boone County.
So this would make Caitlin's great uncle.
This is getting creepy as hell.
Okay.
That guy's creepy.
Who the hell's this? Who's in the army? Yeah, the photo. Can't see the name.
Isn't
DeSoto.
Isn't it her?
Last name's DeSoto. No, it's not her.
Soto? Really?
Like DeSoto. Grab the pen. What? We don't need the pen. Do we need the pens? No. Okay, I'm closing the door. Paris.
Hey, oh. It's one of the postcards I sent.
From August 94. Hi, Mom, Dad, and Sam. I'm in Paris. I have done many Parisian things, including eating Le Petit Jeunet and wearing a beret. I'm going to have lots of film to develop when I get back. Sam, I'm bringing you back something from the Shakespeare Book Company since you are my favorite sister. Love you all, Katie. Mom, Dad, and Sam, 1 Arbor Hill, Boone County, Oregon, 97141 USA. Weird. What? Why is that weird?
Why would you write weird?
Yeah. And why? Who's that girl that's... Who's DeSoto? Do you hear that? Do you hear that, John?
What? The guy talking?
Yeah. It's a radio, right? Please tell me it's a radio.
The TV.
Oh. Hey, okay, now I'm in the room on the right.
The right door?
Yeah, right after that. What's it called?
It's a room with,
a radiator, bookshelves.
Examine paper.
Boone County. Oh, another
chalkboard.
Fan turns on.
Like a bulletin board. Early.
Up.
Space. Utopia. Ernst. JFK president.
What?
Paradox.
Wait,
results
what?
In Jack Bill.
Sent back in time to Dallas 1963 again? What if JFK
you
wasn't
can
JFK?
Do...
Better.
This has got to be the dad's workspace.
Yeah.
Grab cup. Turn lamp on.
Mastery is not
examine
a question
paper?
Of specialization, but sureness of purpose and dedication to craft. If you happen to be in the market for a combination LD CD player, you'll be glad to know that Pioneer seems to share this particular.
The fuck does this mean? What is this? What's a Pioneer CLD D707? Compact disc player?
I suppose.
Expensive.
Yeah. Nothing in the drawer.
Highlighter?
Nothing in either of the drawers. What are you gonna do with the highlighter? Throw it on the floor. I forgot you can crouch.
Nothing in these drawers?
Nope. Oh, what's on the chair? Book. The Killing of JFK, a Theory by Benjamin
Olmsted.
There's
a three-ring binder. Nothing in it, though. Ooh, there's a crumbled paper.
Where?
Read crumbled pages. Right near the wastebasket.
There's nothing
John Russell open.
Oh, there's a form to
John
examine.
Russell.
Electrical inspector
John
form.
Russell opened his... The hell's this? John Russell opened his eyes and saw them. The stars twinkling as if he were lying on the grass in his family's yard in Massachusetts. Even though that place was a million miles away, no. He blinked the sleep from his eyes, looking through the carbon reinforced safety glass of the space station Archimedes. Yes, he was a long way from home, but the future needed him. That's page 1 of 3. John Russell's head swam. He felt incredibly drunk. Despite not having touched a drop in hours, he vomited onto his feet, his bare feet. He stared for a moment, processing his sick, flecked toenails, scanning up his bare shins, bare knees. He was completely naked. He looked up and met the eyes of a gorgeous blonde woman wearing a tight polymer fiber tunic and fabric that strand at the seams to contain her generous bosom was emblazoned with the phrase "Matter Transference Operator." Then he passed out. The fuck?
Okay, on to number
John
3.
John Russell. You already read it?
No, keep going.
John Russell has crossed the gap in time. Only messages has passed before, but now...
With a typo.
Yeah, mad typos. They needed him no more than ever. Changing the past was no longer good enough. Instructions from the council had been clear, but to...
I think that's a typo. From the council.
How to assemble it. He made the machine how to transport his body across time. And now, this is useless.
Yeah, well, it's part of his reading, his, like, author work. Go look in the fucking drawer. There's a electrical form.
The killing of JFK, a theory. You've seen the move, discover the truth.
No, well, yeah, there's that book. But then there's, inside the drawer, in the desk, there's an electrical inspection form. For Terrence Greenbrier, One Arbor Hill, Boone County, Oregon, 97141. Tyler.
The one with the typewriter?
No, the other one.
Examine form. Electrical inspection form. Does this entire electrical system meet local code? Yes. Are there any deficiencies which need correction? Unclear. If yes, describe in detail. Wiring in house is technically up to safety and amperage requirements. However, multiple layer of wiring have been added into structure over the last 100 years. System is frequently unpredictable. Lights blink out for no clear reason. Pressure on floorboards and door frames disrupts circuit wire directly behind the surface. Properly reworking the electrical system would be highly destructive to the walls, floor, and fixtures of the structure. After discussion with Mr. Greenbrier, since there are no current safety concerns, issues will not be addressed. Company, so, Black Cat Electrical Company.
Oh, that's not weird. Black Cat. Lights
Harold flicker. Price Jr. Okay, the house is possessed.
It was inspected September of 94. Okay, are we done with this room? Oh, I think this door was locked. Nope, this door is open.
Some newspaper.
Shit. I don't want to go in that door, John.
Did you ever look in this file cabinet?
Yeah, there's nothing there.
Oh, it has a combination.
Where? Oh, that one. No, I did not.
Enter combination. You can open the first one, but there's nothing. You can't look in it. Top one's locked.
So what's the
by
code?
Combination. Okay. We safe to go in the next room?
No. It's not safe to do anything in this place. There's a crumpled note right here.
Clear.
What?
Are you in the room or not?
No, go back to the hallway.
Why are we back in the hallway?
Because I don't want to go in that room.
Well, we don't have a choice.
Well, we gotta go back into the hallway first.
Okay, right. Where'd you go?
To the left of the door, there's a trash can, and then there's a crumpled note there. Are you the new girl, Sam?
You went all the way through the hallway?
No. Stop at the rug.
Okay. Oh, okay, I see it.
Yeah, you see the note?
Oh, shit. Hey, are you the new girl, Sam? I'm Tommy. I'm at the back. Behind you, wave if you get this, and right back. Hi, Tommy. Yes, I'm Samantha, and yes, I'm new. What's up? I just thought, since you're new, maybe you could use a friend. I don't have a lot of friends either, and so thought I'd ask something if you don't mind. Do you mind? No. Okay. No, I don't mind. What did you want to ask? Was it just your uncle who went psycho, or does it run in the family? So, okay, maybe that dude that has the obituary is her uncle.
No, it's her great uncle, and he went psycho in this house.
Yeah, but is it that dude that has the obituary?
Yes, because in the obituary it says his nephew Terrence Greenbrier, which is this bitch's dad. So it's this broad's great uncle.
All right, this is creepy as fuck, Bell.
Died in the house.
Getting the chills.
Died in the house.
I'm getting scared.
Which is why it's the psycho house or mansion, whatever they called it. Remember?
Yeah.
We gotta find a 4-digit code for that, for this thing. So we can.
Should we go in that next room or no?
I don't think we have a choice.
Okay, let's go then.
Hold on, let me try one code. Nope, guess it's not 1963. Ready?
Oh, kid!
There's a light switch to the left of that door that you come in.
You scared the shit out of me.
These bookshelves don't have anything on them.
It's gotta be something.
Nothing on the bookshelves. Oh, that's thunder.
What's the creaking sounds?
You walking! What do you mean, what's the creaking?
I'm at these two chairs.
The Accidental Pariah. Terrence Greenberg. He published a book.
Tissue.
A James Bond.
Coaster?
Oh, Dad's got porn.
What?
Dad's got porn.
You did not find porn, kid.
I did. February 1989, The New Rules of Love, Ladies in the Ring, The Women of Wrestling.
What about this magazine?
What magazine?
True Story, the one that's on the table. True Stories, I Was a Teenage Drag Queen. May 95, readers tell us about their worst moments. 90210, does anybody still care? The male gaze, how to subvert it.
I'm not looking at that. Wait, you're
useless. Already,
hold on. Okay, so True Stories, I Was a Teenage Drag Queen. I'm looking at this. Sarah Holst, Non-Gathering Moss, The Male Gaze. How does it work?
Ooh, there's a note.
Tissue dogs.
I found a note. There's a note underneath the newspaper. Hello.
The Accidental Patriarch, Villain, Ambassador, Messiah, the Occasional, Sometime, Unreliable, Savior, Hero, A Year on the Mountain, Come Down from the Mountain, The Accidental Prophet, The Unreliable Prophecy.
What does any of that mean?
Prophet. I have no Plug in light. Ooh, turn on the lamp. More lights, the better. Coaster. Okay.
Ooh, I found a box.
Yeah, with books in it. Take all the books out.
Can you take it out?
Yeah, just take them out and throw them on the floor.
Oh shit, porn.
I told you, kid.
Son of a bitch. Dirty bastard. You pick it up and read it? Gosh, Dad. Gentlemen. Japanese bloody war on dolphins? What? Ladies in the ring, the woman of wrestling. Moscow by night, drug, prostitution, the mafia. Just puts it back. Okay. As a book. A stranger under my roof. The number one best-selling advice book for parents of teens. Dr. Elisa Medina. Stranger under my roof, understanding teens. Teen years. He's trying to understand his daughter, I guess. Oh, there's a notebook. Folder. Read letter. Inside the one of the bookcases. Oh,
okay.
November 1st, 1994. David asked me to write you regarding the reviews you've been submitting the last few months. Frankly, they're becoming more terrible than they're worth. From an editing standpoint, there's a word limit. It's your job to stay under it, not mine to cut back to it. Even then, it's becoming harder and harder to weed out the tangents and non sequiturs. I don't know what that was.
Non sequiturs. It means like out of orders. Things that don't line up.
From the usable copy without heavy rewrites, the readers of home theater aficionado want to hear about the quality and value of the hardware, not ruminations on your childhood. If it were up to me, I couldn't be writing this letter. I'd just be cutting you loose. There's tons of guys half your age who would take half your rate to write stuff that actually used, but David's known you for a long time and he's the boss. So I'm giving you the more shot on his say-so. You should write him a nice note thanking him for his patience and generosity. Look through your old stuff and start submitting reviews like that again, then somebody will be happy. Brent Kurtwood, reviewer editor, Home Theater Aficionado Magazine. Okay, I guess he sucks. He's being bashed.
I think that's it. There's nothing else in the room.
Head out then?
You mean the rest of this creepy fucking house? Yeah. Oh, wait, hold on. What? Oh, that's the lid. Okay. Why is this door closed? I didn't close the door.
What door?
The door you came in.
Mine wasn't closed.
Maybe I closed it. Okay, next room.
Back in the hallway.
Yeah, I know. Into the room with the TV.
Severe weather warning. The northwest Northwest Weather Service reports high winds and torrential rain
left
conditions affecting the following counties. Austin County, Boone County.
Some lights on here.
Yeah, right.
County, and Wistaria County.
Girl Scout.
Residents are
role model.
To stay indoors and secure all windows and doors.
Oh.
Flood conditions are expected at lower elevations.
Music.
Maybe they left because there was a warning sign. It looks like they were gonna start a fire. Because there's matches and wood.
This is a severe weather warning. The Northwest Weather Service reports
play the tape.
High winds and torrential rain conditions affecting the following counties. Austin County.
What tape?
County,
the one that's on the table by the door, by the lamp. Yeah, they were urged to stay indoors. Why would they leave?
Music.
Friday, February 17, 1995. The X-Files. They were gonna watch the X-Files.
This is a severe weather warning. The Northwest Weather Service reports high winds and torrential rain.
This room is creeping me out.
Following counties: Austin County, Boone County, Dawn County.
Not a letter. It's that book Dad wrote.
Are strongly urged to stay indoors and secure
accidental savior.
Indoors. Flood conditions are expected at lower elevations.
Okay. There's a note. February 3rd, 1978. Hey man, how have you been? I know you're a published author and everything now. My editor at Hi-Fi Aficionado has too much review work to go around, and he's looking for another freelancer. Naturally, I thought of you. You were saying in your last letter how much of a pain it's been trying to find a publisher from your latest work of literature, and writing stereo reviews is dead simple. Sit at home with a glass of scotch, listen to some records, and write up how it sounds, and then get paid. I've included some issues of the mag to use for examples. If you're interested, send some samples to my editor and tell him your old college. Mike sent you. Here's the address. David Winning, review editors, Hi-Fi Fisher Magazine, 88 Downing Street, Suit 4, do it, Mike. This is an old note. 1978.
Residents are strongly urged to stay indoors and secure all windows and doors. Flood conditions are expected at lower elevations.
VHS.
This is a severe weather.
I'm shutting this TV off. It's creeping me out. Damn book. Sam thought this might help. Dad. Making friends. Feeling lonely? It's a piece of cake to make friends. Never worry again about having friends to spend time with. This book will teach you to make friends even when you're shy.
This is a severe weather warning. The Northwest Weather Service reports high winds and torrential rain conditions affecting the following counties: Austin County, Boone County, Dawn County, Takelma County, and Wistaria County. Residents are strongly urged to stay indoors and secure all windows and doors. Flood conditions are expected at lower elevations.
Okay, so we had three journal entries. August 20th, 94, at the new home. First day of school in Big Gold tour, September 13th, 1994. The Northwest Weather Service. You know the feeling for the biggest moment you've slotted. Counties:
Austin County, Boone County, Dawn County, Takelma County, and Wistaria County. Residents are strongly urged
okay.
to stay indoors.
Wait, hold on. So I'm looking. So did you look at the TV guide?
I just picked. I picked up the book near the television, and one of those diary things popped up.
Pizza box. It's empty. They obviously weren't cooking.
Another button.
This is a severe weather warning. The Northwest Weather
Service.
High winds and torrential rain conditions affecting the following counties.
There's nothing else going on. Okay, this TV has to go off.
I shut it off too.
Sam thought this might help Dad. Piece of cake, my friends, don't worry again about having friends. Even when you're shy. Philip Ackerman.
You know that feeling?
You know it's weird? There was a VCR in this spot.
It's like they have a big gold star around them.
The wires are hanging out.
You have to get to know them. Well, there's this girl. I think
the
she's
fuck
a senior.
Takes all,
she's
VCR.
Usually dressed kind of punk. But sometimes I see her in this, like, army uniform. And she's always drawing
Late.
In this notebook. Looking so intense. I had no idea how I would ever, have an excuse to talk to her. Till I noticed she and her friends hang out and play Street Fighter at the 7-Eleven every day after school.
Reading a packing slip. David Warning, Hi-Fi Aficionado Magazine, 88 Downing Street, New York, New York. Notify sender of new address.
She's in love with the girl with that DeSoto girl.
Maybe.
What do you mean maybe? Did you listen to the last journal?
Was that the girl?
Yeah.
Said the name?
Listen to the journal again. Big gold star, listen. Don't talk, just listen.
It says it.
Well, there's this girl. I think she's a senior. She's usually dressed kind of punk, but sometimes she's here in this, army uniform. And she's always drawing in this notebook looking so intense.
Okay.
So she's got something's going on with this. She's in love with this army girl. Maybe that's why she went on a year-long trip around Europe. Maybe she was following the girl. That dad's book. Okay, let's see. He wrote another book. Terrence, The Accidental Savior. There's another note. February 3rd, 1978.
Yeah, I've seen that one.
And have you been? I know you're a published author, blah, blah, blah.
You know where the box with the packing slip, there's another note. Enclosed, find a Pioneer CLD-707 unit with remote and cables. We need half-page review for the October issue, so that gives you about 2 weeks to get us the copy for edit. Standard stuff like you give us on the CLD-D50T is a combo player, so check its CD playback with a few discs as well as laser disc, and they want to definitely hit the signal-to-noise ratio. And Toslink stuff for high-end buyers. Looking forward to your take on it. Enjoy the unit.
Okay, ready to open
maybe this door. They were installing a DVD player or a VHS player, I should say.
Or something.
But where did it go? Not in the box. Box is empty. Any pizza?
Ooh, there's a story in the closet.
They made a little fort. Why would they be hunting in poltergeist?
Poltergeist? Poltergeist are like evil spirits.
Yeah, but why is that underneath this little fort?
What are you talking about?
It's creepy. See the little fort near the couch?
Oh, soda.
Kid
fuck
me?
You, soda. Hunting's in poltergeist. Leonard O'Rourke. Truth behind stories that are familiar even to our pagan ancestors. Discover how to tell a hoax from a genuine haunting. How to categorize and understand strange phenomena you may encounter. Learn about the unhappy spirits that share the earth with us and what they can teach us about our connection with natural world. The Dogwood paperback. Okay, because that's not weird. Grab the pillow. Throw it. They were obviously sticking it out for something. Go in the closet.
Candle. Go in the closet, you said?
Yeah, she wrote a story. I'm not reading this one. This is a long storybook. Nothing here. Nothing in the
Captain.
Story. We just have to remember Captain.
How do you know?
Because I just read it.
Captain
O. Fine, you can read it.
Captain Allegra looked off at the ocean. It went on forever. Or so it seems. Someday she would find the edge, get to the paradise there. Then she heard a cannon, fire, boom. It was the black pirate ship. She yelled, I thought we lost them at Horse Island. The first mate said, look like you thought too soon. The black ship came up along the side. Captain Black himself came out of the deck of the black ship. He yelled to Captain Allegra, you never gonna find the edge. There ain't no paradise. Ain't your father we're a liar? Captain Allegra yelled back, then why do you keep following us, you imbecile? The first mate yelled out, we'll stop you, Captain Black. Sounds like Bailey's writing. Ah, well.
Edge of the world, and you'll see her father was no liar. The battle kept going until Captain Allegra's ship got away. Now west, she said, and the ship sailed towards the sunset.
Benefit of that. We
back,
need.
Back to the hallway. So we know who this DeSoto girl is. Rod's main squeeze.
See that person run by?
Shut up.
Just kidding.
Wait, hold on. I gotta look at that DeSoto picture again. She's kind of pretty.
She look like a butch?
No, you've seen the picture of her.
Just threw it on the floor.
Okay, moving forward. Bunch of cards. Like coupons. Pen, eraser. Pamphlet. U.S. Department of Agriculture, National Forestry Manual.
That's the mother's,
Yeah, that's all the mother's
what
stuff.
What she does
yeah.
for a living.
Ready to go in this next room on the left?
Yeah.
Is that you breathing?
This is a big room.
Which means it's gonna be... Just gravitate towards the lights.
Open cabinet.
Creepy. Yeah, open the cabinet and turn on the light. There's a letter. Samantha, please give this to your mother. Janice, thank you for having Danny over to your new home. He has missed having his friend Samantha in the neighborhood very much. Danny asked if he could lend Samantha his Nintendo Street Fighting tape. And I gave my permission. He needs to spend less time with those games anyway. No hurry returning it. Let Samantha know that she is welcome back to her house to visit anytime. Sincerely, Mary Schutz.
Where'd you see
when
that?
You live in one place your
closet.
Whole life. Your next door neighbor is kind of like
triggers
your
audio.
Default friend. And Daniel only got weirder over the years. So moving away has been a good excuse to, like, not see him anymore. But he did always have the good Nintendo games.
In the lid?
Maybe I'll give him a call.
No, in the shirt. Okay, that was weird. I just got the chills. I don't know if it was just the uncle that died in the home. I think this Danny kid also died in the home. But then again, he wrote that note, so maybe it wasn't him. I don't know, she was talking about him getting weirder over time. Okay. There's some kind of creaking. I'm not even joking. It was like creaking. And I was in the closet. Not moving. I don't want to play this anymore.
Go in the closet and shut the lights off.
No, I'm not playing this game anymore, John. I'm done.
Why? We gotta break the code, kid. We gotta do this. Little bar here.
Ooh, there's a note. Behind the bar.
Read the letter?
Of Donald Fripp's publisher, Mercury Books, March 76. But we're only in... What? Oh, 76. Mercury Books will be unable to publish a follow-up to the Axel Drive despite the low sales of Accidental Savior, and end with publication of the second book in hopes that the John Ronson series catching on. However, sales of the second book have in fact been lower than those of the first, and so our stewardship of the series must end here. It has been a pleasure working as your publisher, and we wish you and John Russell the best in your future endeavors. Sincerely, Donald Fripps, publisher, Mercury Books. He's a drunk.
Why would he keep this, though? It's his second book. What is this? Grab bottle.
I don't know, you could probably drink it. Just throwing it on the floor.
Another one. Is there a light over here? Dark.
Oh, you can play the record. Yeah, cause that music's not creepy or anything.
Somehow I always.
Okay, that's gotta stop right now.
This is our old-timey record that we got from archive.org, source of all good things.
Okay, waste.
Archive.org, source of all
textbook.
Good it's
world history.
By Adrian Rollini.
Well, we don't need this. This is going
the
trash.
The Tap Room Gang.
There's a folder and an assignment inside. Samantha Greenbrier.
And the doc.
Reproductive system worksheet.
the Adrian Rollini.
Menstrual cycle. It travels through the fallopian tube.
And helping source the soundtrack for that.
Comes out through the vagina.
A lot of listening.
Really? They're giving this to like a fucking how old year old?
Big band stuff.
I am produced in the testicles.
I really liked, and so it was cool to be able to revisit that.
Early morning, September 1st, 1939. Damn, this is fucking long. She got... Look what the teacher wrote. See me. What did she write that was bad?
Okay. The early morning of September 1st, 1939, Essa Glatt stares out the window of the train as it travels from Vienna back to her home village of Wieland in Poland. As the train rumbles along and the sun rises over the countryside, she can only think of her dear Borislav, the boy she is engaged to wed. Meanwhile, deep within her guts, an open starts to develop. Essa's train approaches its destination. Her heart races. The lining of the uterus is getting thick and soft. No. How old is this broad? Hold on. As Essa steps off the train, her eyes dart quickly across the gathered crowd. Then there, her dear Boris, still in his baker's smock. He must have dropped his early morning duties at his father's shop to come meet her. Her heart skips a beat. The ovary releases the ovum. It travels through the fallopian tube. Over the wheezing of the steam engines, a deep hum grows. It's coming from the sky. Dark shadows pass over the station. A whistling sound, Asa, her thoughts only a second faster than the bombs, reaches out toward her dear Boris across the crowd. Their eyes look, and the moment freezes. The flash and smoke envelops him almost instantly. In the assault by German forces, almost 75% of the people in her hometown are killed. The rest, including Asa, and, for a time, Borislav, huddle in a half-destroyed church. He is blind. His legs are missing. Bandaged with torn bedsheets, Asa's egg will not be meeting a sperm. It dissolves.
What the?
About 2 weeks later, Boris loses his grip on life. Asa has given up her rations to keep Boris alive, but in the end, nothing can save him. Since the lining of the uterus is not needed for a pregnancy, it comes out through the vagina. Asa vows to survive. She sets off to join the Polish resistance as a daring spy and saboteur. Another ovum starts to develop in one of the ovaries, and the process begins again. It is incredible how the female body knows how to prepare for pregnancy. See me.
I don't get it. The fuck? Why would she write see me, though? I don't get it.
Obviously, the story was a little much.
Okay.
Lower two stories, the events are all out of order. Get a
Wait,
sheet of lined
this
paper.
This is what her assignment was.
Top, then choose one of the two stories and rewrite it. Begin with the title and your name. Find a topic sentence to begin your paragraph. Put the sentences in chronological order. Make sure the last sentence is a good concluding statement. Oh, she...
Okay, did she...
I mean, yeah, she kind of went through the order. I mean, okay. Girl's got some imagination, I suppose.
She put imagination to it, so why would...
I think it's irrelevant.
The see me?
Yeah. I think, I mean, the story was a little much for just a simple, like, I mean, she was talking about, like, Nazis blowing shit up and stuff, like, going back to World War II type shit.
Right,
not quite
yeah.
Sure the teacher was really expecting that. I don't think there's much else in this room unless you can find something.
Nope, nothing.
Oh, there's another bottle up top. Nope, I'm gonna throw it on the floor.
What the fuck? This pamphlet is floating in the air.
Where? I don't believe you.
Must have been a glitch. Okay, did you exit the room? There's a...
Yeah.
Draw. Open draw. Highlighter in it. Nothing.
Why would there be two random highlighters in the drawer?
A note.
Where?
Ugh, there's a note inside. The bottom drawer.
So if you wanted to come over to my house still this afternoon, that would be cool. I can drive. It's kind of far, but I can drive you home too, so hopefully that's fine. Write back and leave this in my locker if you still want to, and we can meet in the parking lot after 6. Samantha. Yeah, I'm totally in. See you there. Then I'm gonna kick your butt. Get ready. Okay, so they're all gonna play video games.
So you know what they say about the best laid plans of mice and men? Yeah, turns out it applies to Street Fighter 2. At least I worked up the courage to walk into the 7-Eleven and ask for a turn, but all that practice at home did not exactly translate in the wild. So after I was finished getting my butt kicked, I followed them outside while they smoked. And that was when she asked me if I was that psycho house girl. But
okay,
then
that must have
she
been
said
the
she's
girl.
Always really wanted to see the psycho house. Her name is Lonnie. She's coming over tomorrow.
Maybe okay. Lonnie's the first name of the army girl?
Lonnie DeSoto?
And then did you read the note? Katie, please tell Mom and Dad sorry about the stuff that's missing. On top.
Yeah.
And there's a note in the trash can. Katie, please, whatever you found, don't tell Mom and Dad. The attic. What?
Oh, the attic is creepy as fuck.
We're not going into the attic.
Well, it was locked, so I couldn't get into it. But it's creepy. That's in the trash can, right?
Yeah. And this door was locked. That goes to the basement.
Does it?
Yeah. Alright, I guess we gotta go back and go up those stairs now. Oh, 3:19, isn't it your bedtime?
It's already that late? Oh, come on. I'm finishing this.
Right now?
Till the end.
Oh my god. Well, is there anything that we know so far conclusively? Like, whoa.
We know about the family. We know for some reason people are freaked out by this house. We know that she's possibly a carpet buncher. We know that she called in a frantic. Yep. We know there was a state of emergency.
Yep.
Or something to that effect. We know that the father's, a failing author.
Did you see this timetable?
Where's that? Where are you?
In the, door creaking. So if you, go back into the room with the telephone and the message machine, and there's like a little desk on the right, you open the drawer, and there's a worldwide timetable in there?
Yeah, I already seen that. So she departed on July 6, 94. She came back 2 years after, right? A little less than that? By a month? Up the stairs we go.
Yeah, 1 second.
Why does Sam not want us to go rummaging through shit?
I don't think it was Sam that didn't want it. I think it was Katie. Oh, wait, maybe, wait, what? Are you sure? I was almost pretty sure that
Katie's the... Katie is us.
Right, we're Katie. Okay.
Sam is the sister. The one that doesn't want us to go rummaging
right
through shit.
Yeah, we're Caitlin.
Dude, these are creepy stairs.
I'm not going up those stairs.
I'm up them.
I'm not going up those stairs. You can't make me go up those stairs.
It's 3:19. Get up the stairs. Got another pack of cards.
Controlled burn scheduled for Boone County. Janice
Newspaper
Greenbrier. Smoke will likely linger in the area throughout the following weekend.
Controlled burn scheduled for Boone County? Is that what you're looking at?
Yeah.
plumes of smoke will rise above the northeastern region. Local will likely linger in the area through the following weekend. Okay. We don't really know much about the mother yet.
We're about to find out. His mother's up to no good. Oh, there's another form to examine. Go through the door to the left. There's a desk.
Read personal calendar?
No, in the drawer. To aid in the upcoming prescribed burn operation, a ranger with expertise in the procedure is being transferred to the station at Log National Force Vector 9294. Please see attached personnel file. Noticing officer of the Long Station, Senior Conservationist Janice Greenbrier, is charged with the supervision of transfer personnel. Duration of transfer will be based upon performance eval as well as the recommendation of the overseeing officer, signed Bruce Pendleton. So someone was transferred to her. Weekly planner, Monday, Wednesday, cooking class, take apron, ballroom dancing on Friday, couples bowling, cooking class, that's what they did, cooked the big
cook meal
for Terry and Sam. Why? There's no dates on that. Okay, so with bowling, cooking, and ballroom dancing. Okay. Now, bookshelf on the left. It's a cassette. For Sam. Bratmobile. Oh.
It's weird hanging out with girls. Daniel was around ever since I was little, and other girls...
Whoa, what's this?
I don't know.
Love Kate, thing.
But being around Lonnie is like...
Yeah.
Instantly just right.
Triggers audio.
I gave her the grand Psycho House tour, and took my revenge on Super Nintendo. And it was like, I don't know. I finally found someone I feel normal around. I drove her home, and she gave me this tape and said, "You have got to listen to this." I haven't stopped playing it since.
Which door are we going in? Sam, stop leaving every damn light on in the house. You're a bad sister. You're as bad as your sister. Dan called again. He wants his Nintendo game back. Oop. Reed sternly worded the letter. Sam was not happy.
To whom it may concern.
Are you at the board? Yeah, you are.
Okay.
So she's 17.
Caution, radiation area, keep out. We going in this room?
Yeah, 1 second, I just need to...
her room. Three-ring binder. Ooh, a tape. Insert tape.
Binder, what? Nothing. Binder's got nothing.
Oh shit!
What?
Insert tape.
Alright, this is dumb. Not happening. Nope. Get rid of that.
Some lesbian rock music.
TV's
Did you hear
on.
The lyrics?
Yeah. Ooh, there's a note under the thing. Codes. Chun-Li moves. Fireball. Lightning kick, helicopter kick, air stomp. Okay, so they're playing games.
Grab cartridge. Oh, it's the game. Adventurous the Cat.
Yeah, that can go.
Chun-Li moves. Yeah, this one is missing a friggin' a cassette thing too. Look, the wires are hanging out.
Yeah, I know, they all are.
Why though?
Oh, here we go, here we go. Some clues. Hope you're good at magic 3D puzzles.
What, the scrutinized thing?
Yeah.
I think I see a chick with a boob.
Nope.
I don't see shit other than... Stare. I ain't staring at this, I'm scared.
There's nothing there.
More games. Super Spitfire. Journey of Crystal.
Hold on, I need to see what's on this other one.
Mom, Sam had this in like fourth grade.
Fish and a shark. Cool. Alright, there were, it was Holy a fish Bible. And a shark.
Board game.
Super Spitfire. Journey. Crystal.
Unchapped. The King's Labyrinth.
That's what I forgot to do.
This broad writes stories as well. It's like her father. Captain Allegra. Still in her flowing skirt. Sturdy jerkin. Ascended the single shining thread into the lower cavern of the labyrinth. She and the first mate on their own now grew closer to their goal of the dead immortal king of the island.
First okay, we've got another combination lock.
The chapter.
Groove exclusive. AIDS in Africa.
This freaky as fuck. Oh, another note underneath the pillow. Hi Lonnie, I wrote this first period. Left it in your locker on the way to school. It's what all the cool kids are doing.
I don't know where you are.
Decided to write... What? In her room.
Yeah, I'm in her room too.
On the rug underneath the pillow, there's a note.
Did you already go in the closet?
Yeah.
Okay, go with the note.
What?
I said go with the note.
Also, here's an idea of something. He drew two cats on a motorcycle. Hey, this is a good idea. What all the cool kids are actually doing is sending each other pages on their beepers. But we're cooler than them because guess what? They can't put this on a beeper. Okay. The drawing of cats was so good that I added a background to make it even better. Maybe I should just stick to writing, though. Haha, I like it. How did you know they were about to be abducted by aliens? Looking at Mr. Fish right now, I feel like he would probably have lots of cats. Also, like his secret shame, he watches 1-0 religiously. I'll ask him about it after class. He said he doesn't have cats and also that he's never watched 90210, but I could see in his eyes he was lying. The teacher?
What? She doesn't have an affair with the teacher. The Brother 150 motorcycle. Me and Dad are building. Want to go for a ride when it's done? Under the bed, there's a fork. And stuff. Ooh, and a note.
Oh, the note. Samantha Greenbrier, Teacher Fletcher. Not a challenging assignment. Metal plaque for family portrait. Reasonable subject. Not complex. I said that Mom and Dad should be replaced with parents. I mean, then just add them underneath. Huh?
So she did really shitty in metal work.
So she threw it under her bed. Brochure, the Brothers 150. This is me and my dad. Our building wanna go for a ride when it's done. Okay. Grab Staggy Stelly.
Original favorite. Ooh, another button. Misfits. Hairbrush.
The highlighter.
Ooh, Sam.
Pencil.
I think the creative writing track would be perfect for you. Summer pre-college program for young scholars, 1995 session. English creating writing. Okay.
Dinosaur Junior. Exclusive AIDS in Africa.
There's got to be something around here with a code on it. We're not reading that book either. Oh wait, what's that?
Ooh, there's a note. Crumbled note. Oh, a disciplinary referral.
Where?
Inside the trash can. Student name Yolanda DeSoto.
What?
Yolanda DeSoto, what? So it's not that girl then.
Well, no, unless Lonnie is short for Yolanda.
It is. It gotta be. It is. Lonnie, yeah,
student,
D.
Look, student signature, Lonnie D.
Yep. 9:20 a.m. Mr. Benchley observed Mrs. DeSoto wearing a t-shirt with an unacceptable image on the front. A large beer can labeled Pabst Blue Ribbon. Mrs. DeSoto was sent to the guidance council office. Action taken by faculty. Mr. Soto was given an option to turn her shirt inside out, change into a shirt from her locker, or be suspended for the rest of the day. Mr. DeSoto chose suspension. The father was called, but there was no answer and no answering machine. Mrs. DeSoto must return this form tomorrow, signed by her father. Administration signature. 10/20/94. Personally, I feel like they've been gone for a while.
Well, obviously.
Because everything's like 1994. She got home 2 years after, like in 96.
No, it's 95 she's home, no? It's 95 she came back, 96. A year abroad. No, June of
95.
96. No, it was June 6th of 95.
Oh, so it's only a year.
Yeah.
Where did I get 96 from then?
I don't know. Alright, ready? Go through this next door.
The brochure. About a pre-college program. I think the creative writing track would be perfect. Three students from each track will be offered a full scholarship in the first year at REIT. That'd be something else. Closet. What's in here? Oh, the hallway?
Are you looking at the door on the other side?
There's two entrances and there's two exits. Yeah, it's another hallway.
Well, I don't think we should go this way. I think we should go back out the first door and then...
It leads to a bathroom. Just goes around, I guess. Just the one big circle.
It's another...
Danger where... On the outside door.
Whoa,
ooh,
this...
a backpack.
This room has been ransacked.
What room?
The next room in the hallway. So
oh,
go
back
look...
the right other way?
Yeah.
This is the parents' bedroom. It's gotta be. Guessing this is the parents' bedroom, no?
I don't know, but why has it been ransacked?
These? Clothes. Nothing in it. Looks like there's male and female clothes in this.
Yeah, it's probably the parents' bedroom.
Look at this. A TV and the thing, the wires are out again. Why is all the VCRs missing?
Well, we know it wasn't DVD players. Because that shit probably wasn't around in fucking 94, 95.
Yeah, but why is all the VCRs missing?
Maybe they got robbed. Kidnapped. Maybe that's why they're missing. Robbed and kidnapped.
Why would you take VCRs on that television?
Ooh, found a condom.
Found a condom?
Yeah, in the bottom drawer. There's nothing I don't hate right now. Bottom right drawer. Closest to the chair.
One with the box on it?
No, the other one.
Oh, I found it. Barf. The hamper. Oh, mittens. Ooh, what does this say? H5 Caitlin. Our cat, Caitlin. H5. Here's another family picture. You're getting uglier by the minute. Ooh, credit cards. What?
Ew, what the hell?
Open draw.
Ooh.
Read letter. Oh, shit, another letter by Karen. Dear Jan. Oh, honey, let me tell you, I understand how you feel. Bob and I have had our down period. It's become a little bit of a way of life, actually. You get used to each other. You live your own lives in the same house. Kids grow up, they go away. Sorry, this isn't helping, is it? Don't worry, Terry will be over whatever's distracting him. Things will go back to normal. And as for Sam being distant, that's a teenager for you. Nothing to worry about. In the meantime, though, this controlled burn, quotation mark.
Did you see the,
controlled what?
The controlled burn.
What does that mean?
They're burning shit, remember?
Oh, okay. That sounds like quite the adventure. But let's...
Did you see the postcard? That's what I want. On the next to the bed.
No. On the other side of the bed?
Yeah, by the telephone.
Dear Mom, Dad, and Sam, I am in the channel. This is my second passage through the channel. I'm on my way back from London. This time going to Brussels, Belgium. Sorry I didn't write you on the way to London, but I was too excited about the channel. London was great. Dad, I know you always wanted to visit. I think you really should. You'd love it if you wanted to come back here as a family. Sometimes I guess I could be advanced. Love you all, Katie. Mom and Dad, Aubrey Hill. I don't get it.
Did you go in the bathroom?
Oh, I'm in the draw. Holy Bible. Damn business card. Unknown Dimension Literature. Newark, New Jersey. Kaz Publisher. Communications must become total conscious before we can stop it. Back. Got a bitch on the floor. Anything under his bed? Ooh, book. Walt Whitman.
Examine the bookmark. Yeah. Take your time. I'm glad to have it in good hands, Rick. Oh, she was having an affair. The ranger that they sent.
Say that again?
Remember the ranger that got transferred? That's Ranger Rick.
That doesn't mean she was having an affair.
He gave her a book.
That means getting parked?
Yeah. Go in this closet, see what we got. Anything in the closet I should be aware of?
Not that I know of. Purse.
A book. Let's see. Watercolor techniques. That can go on the floor.
Bathroom.
Let's see what's in the bathroom. Hairbrush. Floor.
Oh, the door. Sliding door. Bathroom. Candles, teepee. exists. After the honeymoon, rediscovering your spouse personally, spiritually, and sexually.
Band-aids. Toothbrush. Shaving cream.
This sucks. Cabinet. You know what I've noticed? There's a lot of freaking bandages around.
Yeah, they're in bathrooms. Alright, well, this room. Ooh, what's in the hamper? Oh, undies. Tidy whities.
Nothing in the bathroom. Oh, look, a ghost game. Escape from Ghost Mansion.
Have you been Ubering lately or no?
No.
They actually called. How many rides did you, like, who did?
They called me.
What do you mean they called you?
Some girl named. She called, her name was Melissa from Uber, wondering why I haven't driven in a while.
What'd you tell her?
I left there. I didn't answer it.
Oh. That's so funny. Are you gonna call her back?
No.
Alright, are you done with the bedroom?
Well, there's no walk-in closet, but there's nothing.
Yeah, there's nothing. I'm gonna go straight across to the window, to that second door from Sam's room. And that hallway, towards the backpack, you know?
Did you ever check the backpack?
No, I'm doing it now, but there's nothing to do, it's just that note under it. Just quote the costume if you came out last week and Todd wouldn't shut about it. Either so good, or we can make fun for liking him. For liking it. My mom is supposed to cook dinner for us tonight for a change, but I can just ditch it on it probably what time. Also, isn't that movie supposed to be really violent? Am I going to barf? According to Todd, it is pretty hardcore. I guess Uma Thurman gets stabbed in the heart with the heroin needle, so that's kind of hilarious. Also, something about cheeseburgers. Important. Todd wants to see it again. 7:15, okay. Don't barf. All right, see you there. And we're gonna barf. Going in this room. It's another bathroom. Oh! There's blood!
Not blood.
Go in the bathroom, there's blood.
No, it ain't.
It is. And what is it?
See this bottle?
Are you sure that's what it is?
Color. Hair dye.
Are you sure about that? Who gets hair dye all over the fucking place like that?
It's red, white hand.
The boxes of tampons that you can find in the washrooms around the house, they weren't originally on the list of items that needed to be modeled, but
you pick up the bottle
at that level of fidelity, and when you're creating a bathroom for a teenage girl, no less, the idea of not having something like that is kind of jarring, or it was kind of jarring to me, especially because when you're at that age, your period is something that kind of really defines your
more bending
in a given day, and maybe what you wear and where you go. So, you know, I just thought it was
there's band-aids, you know, everywhere.
Necessary for visual storytelling, especially of a girl going through what she's going through.
Another diary thing.
A lot of Gone Home is about pointless interactivity. That is sort of things being interactive for the sake of them being interactive. Oh, but it really comes from
joint?
Our inspirations of immersive
what's
sims,
this?
Oh, like System Shock and BioShock and Thief, where a big part of the design philosophy behind those games and Gone Home is that
is there a storyline here that we're supposed to be figuring out? Consistent.
And there's this feeling that if there's something that your character might do, you should be able
to
do
it
in the game. So, for instance, you can flush all the toilets and you can turn on all of the faucets, and that's also
the cabinet.
Deus Ex and Dishonored. It's like, irritating. And sometimes, you know, like the water fountains in Deus Ex give you like one health or whatever, but really, you can interact with them because there's this expectation of
where are you now?
If you could interact with that, if you encountered it,
leaving
in this
now,
world, we should let you do that, right? So, you know, all of the faucets in our game can be turned on, and they can be turned on so that you can turn them on and you can flush all the toilets, and it extends into our philosophy behind you can pick up every plastic cup and toothbrush and Kleenex box, not because it's going to add a whole lot to your understanding of this world to be able to look at the underside of a cup, but to pay off that expectation and say to the player, yeah, you could pick that up and look at it, so we're going to let you do that, and it's going to be consistent interactively with the stuff that is important, and that makes it your job to look at everything and give it your attention and for you to decide and understand and figure out what has significance and what doesn't.
Katie, mom and dad were going to make
tell that
guest
to you
room in over the summer, but you came home on such short notice that they weren't around to do it. You can use my room if you want. Won't be needing it anymore.
Why won't you be needing it anymore, though?
That's the creepy part. Examine composition book. Samantha Greenbear, ghost hunter journal. Sighting journal. Oh shit. August 31st, 1994, at 1:19 a.m. A tall shadow in the upstairs hall.
Oh no.
When I rounded the corner, no one was there. How tall was Uncle Oscar? Note, I was not wearing my glasses. What? September 3rd, 1994, 12:44 a.m., a faint voice coming from the bottom of the stairs. I said hello, did not investigate, probably was the furnace. September 9th, 1994, 4:11 p.m., poured milk from carton in fridge. It was spoiled. Pretty sure I read that spirits can sour milk. Milk was just bought yesterday. Whoa. Page 3. October 9, 1994, 11:24 p.m. Lonnie says she feels a pressure in the TV room. I suddenly begin to feel cold. We build
presence.
A protective pillow for. Okay. October 29, 1994, 11 p.m., 12 a.m. Lonnie and I employed Ouija board as a medium.
No.
Disturbing messages are conveyed from the other side. Oscar is definitely here. October 28th, 1994, 10 p.m. October 29th, 4 a.m. Enlisted Lonnie to... What does that say? Enlisted Lonnie to stay up all night and help patrol premises, recording any signs of otherworldly presence. Lonnie reported many sightings, but all remain unconfirmed. Possible ectoplasm in the attic. Probably.
Yo, we're not getting into the attic. We're not going to the attic.
Sample taking just in case. Despite due to our best effort, we both fell asleep around 4 a.m. All in all, a successful night. Alright, and now I'm...
Did you read the note? Hey,
another
Sam.
Note.
You were asking what my junior ROTC... ribbons meant. Here's a handy guide. Orienteering means the army thinks I can find my way around. Rifle team, the army has branded me as a certified killing machine. Adventure trailing, I am a born adventurous, and no borders can hold me. The army recognizes this. So if you didn't think I was cool before, now you do want a D. Okay.
Miscellaneous.
It's just boxes. There's nothing here. This is Katie's room, but it was never made up.
Sliding door. More boxes. There's literally nothing in this room. There's two notes.
No, gotta move forward.
What is this? Room? This is the red thing right here.
What thing?
Shit, what is this?
How did that door get open?
What?
John, is your door open?
For what? What? This room right here that has the portrait thing?
What room are you in?
Picture of a plant.
Hold on.
The room next door. Coaster. Examine form. Performance evaluation. Richard Hattermack. Supervisor Janice Greengrave. It's an evaluation sheet. Temporary. Supervisor comments. Ranger Padamet has been indispensable during the course of pre-described burn preparation and execution. His expertise and dedication has been a decided factor in the success of a very complex Taliban effort. In the opinion of the Flintlock Force staff, Rick's contributions to daily operations have...
Ooh, a tape.
Where did you find the tape?
In the painting room. There's nothing to play it on.
A note. Yeah, there's Halloween show, The Misfits. They're awesome. See you there. Don't forget your costume. 10:29, 4 p.m. Bye to mom. Dad's chosen.
Oh no.
Sometimes you just have to lie to mom and dad. Like when Lonnie asked me to see a band with her and stay over at her friend's place in the city after. That's a lie to mom and dad's situation. But it was so worth it.
Okay.
The girls on stage were just so loud and real and awesome.
Did you
and everybody
find
was moving it? Together like one huge tide of sound.
Did you find a cassette? Where'd you find
Between
the cassette?
Between two songs, Lonnie leaned over and said, "How do you like your first show?"
On the chair.
I was so
in
happy. I felt tears starting in my eyes. And then she up and hugged me. I think she could tell.
There's a cassette player right here.
Found it, yeah.
Anything?
Oh god, no, that's like the ghost call sound. No. Oh god, no. Hell no. Get that tape away from me.
Rock music.
No, it's not rock music.
I got music on mine.
Yeah, I know. It's like some loud whistling, hissing sound.
Horrendous lyrics.
What's worse, the lyrics on that tape, or Jared's lyrics?
What's worse?
Yeah.
Jared's. Another room, grab a textbook. Healthy Choices, Skills for Healthy Life. 1993, 4th edition. Open folder. Damn map. Lonnie, holy crap, I was in the library and noticed something in the corner. What is this?
Hold on, where are you?
Holy crap. There's another room off of the that room.
Yeah, I know. I'm in it.
And there's a note. It says, holy crap, I was in the library and I noticed something in the corner. And I found a secret passage and it had Oscar's creepy old stuff in it. Oh my god, I have got to see this. We're skipping 6. Period. We have to find this room, I think. Shit.
Yeah, it's behind the closet.
Or even... Should we go to that spot? Or should we keep looking? Bowling table?
Bowling table pops open.
Examine book.
Wildfire. He saved her from the raging flames, and then things really heated up. Let me know when you're ready to move forward down this hallway to the red room.
You can move forward.
What? Can't get in it.
Damn, stock room, do not enter.
Because that's the attic.
Lights are on.
Okay, no, no, no. We're not going into the attic.
We can't open it anyway. Is there any other rooms that we haven't looked through?
Not up here.
Guess we if have not, the only thing.
Dad's room. And go through that secret passage.
Are we going to be able to find that?
Shit. I just opened it.
Opened what?
The secret passage!
How did you get there? Oh, relax. Don't go in it yet, because I'm confused.
Mom and Dad's bedroom, the purple one, remember with the condom in it?
Okay, hold on.
On the left, there's a closet.
Okay, all the way to the left. Closet? That walk-in closet?
Yeah, go in the closet, go to the back wall, and open the panel.
Oh my god, I'm scared now. What is this?
Is there lights?
Oh, fuck.
Are there lights?
There's a pull light.
Where?
Cobwebs. Pull string. Oh my god, what is this?
John, I don't want to go down there.
There's a note. There's another map. Oh no.
You mean there's another map?
Another open panel. There's another examine map. Ghost Hunters, Sam and Lonnie's secret house investigation log. Hidden compartments found 3. Library, upstairs hall, and foyer. Evidence of supernatural. Did you see it?
Hold on, I'm looking at it now. Wait, so Sam is... So Katie's not the one in love with the Lonnie. It's the Sam girl. It's the sister.
Yeah, Sam and the Lonnie. There's 3 hidden compartments. One in the library, one in the upstairs hall, and one in the foyer. Hidden compartments marked on map. Oh, they go on the map. There's another open panel here all the way to the right.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, that's going to be... That's
did you open it
yet? Go to the library. I just did.
Go to the library.
Yeah, go to the library that we were just in. Okay.
Where's the last one that we happen to go to? It's one more hidden spot, right?
One in Dad's office.
Library.
Go to Dad's office on the map.
That's upstairs, right? Or downstairs? Oh, it's right here. Dad's office. Where's the secret passage?
Oh, it's on the other side. Here it is.
Eh?
Go back into the library.
At Todd's brother's place after the show, there was only a futon.
There's a typewriter, right?
So Lonnie and I shared it. The lights went out.
No.
I was turned toward
the
library.
My eyes started
to
adjust.
Radiator to the right, in the corner.
She was looking at me, too. In the dark, she smiled. My heart was beating so fast. I rolled over. I felt so...
In the library or in his office?
In the library.
After a minute, she put her arm around me. And was so close and whispered in my ear... I really like you.
Okay.
I just nodded my head, and I really hope she could tell.
Oh, shit.
I really
grab loose panel.
That she meant what I think she did.
Okay.
I felt like a shook-up can of soda ever since.
Show flyer?
I hope we have the chance to talk before we explode.
Okay, so now what? Now what? Is there another spot that we have to find?
Yeah. Found it. And it's the Ouija board.
On what?
The other loose panel. Go back upstairs.
Wait, how did you find it, though? Is it on the map?
Yeah. Go to the bathroom across the hall from Kate's room, or from Sam's room, rather.
Hey, Pat, you said upstairs, right?
Yeah. Go straight out of the bedroom. Straight across the hall, right under the lamp, there's a panel. Half of Sam's...
Bedroom to the right?
You don't even need to go into the bedroom. Just go straight across the hall from the parents' bedroom. Or, like, where that backpack in the hallway was. And right to the on the left side, there's a lamp on the wall. Right below the lamp, there's a loose panel. Okay, that's really kind of weird. Stupid. Creepy.
Wait, calm down. Relax. Okay, so near the it's near the backpack?
Yeah, so if you look at the backpack.
Right.
Look to the left. There's a lamp on the wall. And then right below the lamp is the loose panel.
Oh, I see it. Ouija board. Read note. Hello, who are you, Oscar? What do you want to come? Take first combo scrap. How was that creepy, though?
No, not the combo, the other one.
The scrap?
No, not the combination scrap, the piece of paper with the Ouija answers on it.
Oh. Now what?
Yeah, good question. Now what? We have to find the other part of the... Yes, I guess. Gotta be a
first half of the combination to Sam's locker. This sucks. What time is it?
4:15.
Oh fuck. Can you save this?
Yeah.
You gonna go ahead?
Nope. You kidding me? This shit's creepy as fuck. I'm not doing it.
Save progress. You quit to main menu. I gotta save. Okay. Back on this tomorrow.
Back on this tomorrow. Stupid fuck.